Hi, welcome to my channel, the Machine Learning Engineer. Today I start a new series of videos where I will speak about data science in Neo4j. Not only I will cover the GDS plugin, the Grab Data Science plugin in Neo4j, I will also comment, not in this video, I will upload the some of them, still don't know how many, but today we will start with the introduction of this really interesting module, very powerful module of the Neo4j, and later on in other videos we will see integrations with common and well-known libraries like LangChain or PyTorch. So like in other occasions, I'm preparing a notebook that later on I will upload to the repository, and you will have access to it, and you will be able to replicate the exercise at home in your environment and at your own convenience. So first of all, we need, and I'm not going to cover in this video what is a graph database, how to work with Cypher. This is not the purpose. If you want to me to do some stuff about that, to introduce how to start working with graph databases like Neo4j, what is Cypher, how to create queries and interrogate a graph database, write me a comment on the channel, and then I will prepare some stuff for people who didn't work with this kind of technologies. But today we will cover what is GDS, Graph Data Science plugin or package in Neo4j, and we will make an introductory example of how it works, and that's it. Also, we will not cover the installation. I will tell you how to connect to the sandbox or to the Neo4j desktop, and again, this in any case, this is something that we cover in other videos that I upload to the channel. Again, if you need something specific, let me know, and I will try to help you to install this and replicate the same I'm gonna say here on this video. So to cover the exercise, you will need a graph database, a Neo4j database. The best is to use the sandbox. I give you a link to the sandbox. You need to register with an email address. They don't ask you for any credit card, anything, and then once you have registered and confirmed your email address, you will get a dashboard like this. I recommend you to use this template, the Graph Data Science. It's coming with the database, the graph database that we are going to use for all these videos. Is the airport airports. Contains all the airports with details and connections all over the world, and then we will be working with that. And then you can install as well at your convenience, or if you prefer to install the desktop, you can do it as well. You can download the desktop to local. I will show you now this. So again, once you have choose the data science template, create, and you will get something like this. You will get a dashboard. I have here two databases. The sandbox, initially you get 3 days free of charge. You can extend it maximum to 10 days. I have here two projects. One is for the conventional movies. This is only a raw database without plugins. Here, the Grad Data Science template comes with the GDS plugin plus APOC, another interesting plugin that is very related and is another package that leverages the use of the GDS. So here on the project, you will get here the first of all the extension. If you need to extend for 10 days, after 7 additional days, you can do it here. After the 10 days is done, is gone. You here have the credentials. You can connect with different technologies, with different languages: JavaScript, Python, Java, Go, C Sharp, and GraphQL. Neo4j is developed in Java, so well, the other ones had SDKs and APIs to connect to the original Java language. But yeah, I always work with Python, and it's working really, really fast, so no problem. So you have here examples in how to connect using the Neo4j client or any of these languages. I also tried the JavaScript one, and the rest, to be honest, I didn't try it. The last thing that you need, you have here, you can make a backup and download this backup. You can download the backup to local and restore the backup in your local environment case that you want to. If you prefer to do it with the desktop, I give you here as well the link to the desktop. But you will need to download and install the International Flights Database to into the. You will need to import it, download it to local, and import it to your local environment. In order to install the local environment, it's just a binary. Let me show you. Once you install the binary, which is next, 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 you don't need to worry for now about other complexities in the configuration. Only install the client, the thick client, and once you have it done, it comes with the Movies DBMS. By default, we will create a new database to load the flights database into it. To create the new database, just git add local DBMS. You can connect to the sandbox as well using the remote connection, it's as you wish. And then once you have it installed, you start the database and you go to the section plugin and install the APOC and Grad Data Science Library plugins. So you don't really need APOC, but as I said, it's very advisable to have it there because it's gonna give you a lot of tools to manipulate text, manipulate data, and do many other things like cosine similarity and other tools. So I will say like kind of the NumPy and SciPy in the graph database or in Neo4j. So the Graph Data Science Library is the machine learning library and other algorithms. So again, you need these two in local just to if you want to replicate this in your local environment. Once you have this done, you can open, and then open it, you get the client, which is something like that. If you are familiar with Neo4j, well, nothing more to explain, no? And you had exactly the same in online. You had well, my yeah, you had the same, but again, the database that we're gonna use for this video and for the next ones is gonna be this one, the airports and flights dataset. And then so we need to have this if you want to obviously to replicate what I'm gonna do here. Okay, so let's move to the code. So again, The initial all the GDS package circulate around a workflow, and once you understand this, it's pretty easy. Everything in the GDS is similar to what we are going to explain here, a little bit more detailed, or some additional steps in the middle if you want to do some specific activities. But what you are going to see here is going to be practically the same regardless the algorithm that you are going to use. You have a database, and then you create a projection. The projection is, if you want to do a simile, is like create a view in a database, in a conventional database. You choose an algorithm. In this case, we are going to use a sorted paths distra. It's exactly the same, like you make a view in a database and you run, I don't know, a merge, if you want to say that. You can run as well other algorithm, and then this produce an output, and you show the output to the user. You can modify this, how to say, the run of this algorithm, some other creating some additional attributes, whatever, etc. This is an iterative process, as you can see here. You can change whatever, probably even only the organization or the order, how you show the or you can create a instead to create the sum of the, in this case we are going to do the sorted path in between two points, and then only probably you want to create an additional average or attributes. At the end of the day, what we're gonna do here is kind of feature engineering. So you can probably want to do some refinement of this, of how you are using, or introduce a new algorithm in this loop. And then once you had everything done, this loop is complete. You are satisfied with the output of the execution of the algorithm or algorithms that you are using on this view. You can decide either to drop the don't do anything, or write back to the database and create an attribute in a relation, create a relationship, create a new attribute in a node, and so on and so forth. So the process is always like this, and this is going to work regardless the algorithm that you decide to use or you need to use. Okay. We are going to use the SDK, Python SDK, to connect to the database. Is something like that. It's just copy paste from what you have here. It's nothing special. Select your language, and that is here. You may see that I'm using the LangChain client, so it's fully integrated with LangChain. We will see this at the end of the series of these tutorials, and probably we will make some RAG tools and also creating embeddings and see how we can use Neo4j for different purposes together with LangChain and with PyTorch. And here we are just making a simple query which just return all the airports in the city of Los Angeles. Very simple. Just exactly, there is only one in that case, or at least one on the database. So the nodes, you can go here. Nodes, we have nodes and relationships, and then you can click in a node. You will get by default a limit of 25, and you get 25 nodes with the relationships that every node had, no? Some relationships are in between nodes of the same class, some other relations are with nodes of different classes. Here we have five classes, and we have these relationships in between nodes, and again, nodes of the same class or nodes or different classes. For example, forget about here path. This is something that I create during the tutorial. So the original relationships are hash routes in city, in country, in region, or on continent. If you click in hash route, you will get the same examples. You are executing here is shown the cipher query that you are executing, and you see the routes. You can see continent as well. Sorry, I wanted to do something like that in country. So you see here in country you had the country, you had airports, you had cities as well. In region, in continent. So here you had again nodes, relationships, and properties. These properties are from nodes or from relationships. So, well, if you click in one of these boxes or nodes, you will get some examples, visual examples. Also, you can get it in text. It's not so initially you will get the graph, but if you want to get the text, you can use it again. Also here text, and also here the code that you need to execute. As well, again, this is the purpose of this video is not to show you how to create queries in Cypher, but here, well, we are just matching anything here. We are not specifying any node that has a relationship country, and we return the node itself. You can specify here, instead to do it here, you can specify p dot airport, and then on you will get only airports. So we are just now limiting the. So here you can show the graph, and then on now we only get here you can use only cities. Probably we need to do this unless that, yeah. So on and so forth. Yeah, you can just start limiting or filtering what you want to show, and then if you click in one of the nodes, you can click in relations, and you will see the relations. Here is the airport, the continent, the country, and here you have some cities. So by default, always limited to 25 nodes in a screen. You can visualize more, but well, it's quite heavily consuming memory. This especially the desktop in your local machine. But you don't see too much this effect in the sandbox. But also, it's not very powerful. It's a serverless application, so well. Better when you are visualizing the data, do it in small groups. Okay, so here you can export as well the data to CSV, to other formats. Well, again, it's not the purpose to show you how to use Neo4j and do queries. We want to see how to use the GDS model. Here you print the schema. Here we make an additional query. Here we are just again doing how many, give me anything that had the relationship in country. And it's taking some seconds. Okay, we had 8,439 nodes that had. It doesn't matter that all these nodes are airports, We can see here this that I saw before is an airport, and this is a country, Zanogro. The vehicle, no, probably it's a region. Ah, exactly, this is a region. Here we are just how to say, filtering a little bit more the query, and we just say that we want everything that is in that has a relation in country, and that that the country code is US. We can say here something a little bit more specific, like P dot city. So we want all the cities that have a relation in country and the where the country code is US, and we return just P. So the cities. Here you have the queries. So if you are familiar with SQL, you may find this quite similar, because essentially it's very close to the SQL language. But well, had some particularities, and you will see now as well how we are interacting with the GDS module is slightly different. So here we obviously had something different, and you can take a look one of the notes. Okay, and now let's go to create here. As I said before, everything starts to creating a projection of your Neo4j database. A projection is like creating a view. View is, you know, that databases is just selecting parts of your database and using this part to do something. It's exactly the same concept. Here, what we're going to do is to create we call it the GDS module, grad class, and we create a projection. The name is airport grad. It's gonna be airport. It's gonna the projection we do using the node airport. The relationship hash road, and we will use to in this projection the property of the relationship, in this case hash road distance. If you go here, relationship hash road, sometimes okay, it's taking a while, but it's more my machine that not the, you see here the distance. Every hash road is a distance. What we're going to do here, we are going to use the sorted path Dijkstra algorithm to calculate the distance, the sorted distance in between two airports in the world. And then once we know that, we will create a new attribute for, in this case, a new relationship in between these two nodes. One is the source and the other is the target. And then we will provide to this new relationship some attributes. And then we start creating the projection. We give a name to the projection. This is the node that we are going to use, the relationships that we are going to use, and the property of the relation that we are going to use. You may use as well properties of the nodes. You can use multiple properties. It's going to depend in which algorithm you are going to use and what needs or what you want to calculate. No, this is kind of feature engineering, as you will see once we cover the notebook. So here we created, okay, so what we do here is we just execute call GDS graph project, blah blah blah. We create the projection, and here we return the database return as the output. So we have created the graph, a new graph. This is a view, as is the concept view in database. It contains 3,503 nodes, these relationships, and this is the time that it costed. to create it. Is the second time or the third time I created, the first time used to take longer because now there is some index. When you create the first time, it had to create some indexes that to, right now they are done, so it's taking very short because the indexes are already created. Now what we're going to do, we are going to, using the projection that we have created, we are going to run an algorithm. So we choose an algorithm and we run it. Okay? From the GDS graph catalog, we choose one and we read and we run it and we produce an string and show to the user. This is exactly what I'm gonna do here. I will explain you. We just take the, we want to match one airport. From an airport, the airport had the attribute IATA. The IATA is the International Airport Code. You see here, for example, this is Raleigh, Durham, and the IATA code is RDU. So we want to use this. Later on, we use other attributes, but for now, we are going to see. I want to know the distance of one node, a specific node. I choose in that case, but we are going to use this one right now, the IATA. Copy. We use it here. And then we're going to use from this place to AST, this is Japan, okay? The airport Akita in Japan. So this is our source, this is our destination. We want to use the shorter path distance algorithm. The projection is going to be airport grad, the projection that we just created here. And then the projection, from the projection we select the source star and the relationship that we want to evaluate in the using the sorted paths algorithm, and we will yield index. Index is the position of the step or the in the path, source node, target node, this is what you specify here. The total cost of the sorted path distance, you may know, is summing up the individual cost of every step on the path, and it choose the shortest to return to the user as a sorted path. And the path is the list of individual steps with all the details. And this is exactly what we are going to return. We return the index, so the position of the path, the source name, the target name, the total cost, that is the sum of the individual cost, and all the nodes as path. And we order this by index. So we execute this. Again, this is very fast because it's already created. And then we can see here Durham, Chicago, Tokyo, Akita. So if you now, you can run this here. If you run it here, obviously, you are gonna get only text, but if you run it here, you will get the, sorry, exactly, you have it here, Raleigh. So I wonder where is Raleigh. I took it, but I don't know where is Chicago, Tokyo, and Aita. We didn't specify the, how to say, the direction. This is probably important as well because we are selecting this as a source and this is a destination. We also can specify that we want a relationship with this direction because it's not the same to have road from Chicago, probably some specialist can tell me, from Chicago to Raleigh. So I don't know how it works, the roads in between international airports, that when you have a road in one destination, mean automatically that you have to have the same road in the opposite direction. Probably yes, eh? I probably have seen a nonsense. But well, in any case, what I'm saying is that this is a bidirectional relationship. You make this, sometimes it's not like that. You only had a relationship in one direction, so the other one doesn't exist. Here, In this case, in this graph, probably means that once you had a road in one direction means that you had the opposite at the same time. Well, and then we already had the road, the algorithm find the shorter path, and then we can see here as well it's a local horse ID page run long printer. So sorry, where is this? One second. Point. One second, I will execute R zero only, no path. So we had total cost exactly source name, but it's not taking so probably because there is nothing as source name. And then we had total cost and we had somewhere as well. Okay, now what we wanna do is we are happy with this. We are gonna create a new relationship which link the source and destination, and we will include the path. The path means all the individual steps that we need to cover from go from source to destination, with also the total cost of this new relationship. We are going to call the relationship path, and it's exactly what we are writing here. So we do the same match source destination. Here we need to change the source because it's RDU. So before I was doing Baltimore to Japan, to this the same airport, and now we are going to create the path from Raleigh to Akita. And we execute again the sorted path, the projection, source, target, distance. We create a new relationship, we write the node, and we write the cost. We execute that. Okay, we write an, and then now this means that we create a new relationship, and this is what you see here, path. You can see now path, and then probably we have hash row Baltimore exactly. Path you see here, as we are using the same Akita as destination, we had a road which is Raleigh. This is exactly what we create right now. So from Raleigh to Akita, and this is the previous example I have, no? And then we have created this new relationship with this path. Path has the cost. You can see here on the right, had node IDs and total cost. The total cost in this case is 7,053. The individual cost you can see here, 0,347, 6,070, blah, blah, blah. And 7,053. If we go to the other one, it has a different total cost, and the nodes ID are different, obviously, and the individual total cost is different. This is what we did here. So here, obviously, we are specifying source and target. We can create a different query where we, for example, execute for one destination to all destinations all over the world, and kind of create a loop and establish a path for any arbitrary source to any destination in the database and create the relationship, and then I'll write it back to the path, and in this way we are creating a new, in this case is exactly a new feature. We later on we can create any features we want with other algorithms with other kind of calculations. These calculations can come from this for the GDS, or can come from the APOC. APOC, as I said, is kind of NumPy, sci-fi, with a lot of the methods to work with text, with other to do other stuff. And then here what we are doing in this specific case, we are creating a new feature that later we can use. And now you can see here we just make a match, source, path, target, and you get here exactly what I created before in the previous video I recorded in Spanish. And now the second one, that is, the first one was Baltimore to Akita, and now is Raleigh to Akita. And that's all. Very interesting stat, in my opinion. I enjoy a lot working with Neo4j. It's very powerful technology, and well, this is just the beginning. We will cover more complicated and complex stat training, ML algorithms, for example, doing classifiers and many other stuff. And the final stuff will be integrating with LangChain and PyTorch for some use cases. We already covered some videos not related to Neo4j, was related to LangChain and how to work with that library. And in some of the use cases, we use Neo4j as graph database or retrieval tool, vector store or retrieval tool. But this series is focusing on Neo4j data science, and then on we will do the opposite, how to leverage the use of LangChain with Neo4j. That's all. Thank you very much for watching. I hope that you enjoy and you find this interesting and useful for your work. And if it is like that, just give me a like and subscribe to the channel if you didn't do it before. Thank you very much. See you soon.